Hello friends and family, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This channel facilitates .NET lessons and projects. So we have a lot of lessons and projects in our playlist, so you can do check it out. In this video, we are going to talk about how to create and publish Android app using PowerShell CLI. Now, the first video that I did on Android publishing, we did that on using the user interface. So this time around, let's see. Can you publish your Android application using the PowerShell command line? Yes, of course. And that is what we are going to have a look today. So there are two ways. You can decide to use the user interface, or you can decide to use the command line, that is a PowerShell. So I will link the video that we did using the interface under the description, so you can check it up. And this also using the PowerShell CLI. So let's see. What you have to do first here is we have to create our project. So let's create our .NET Maui app project. So this is a Visual Studio 2022, and we launch it up. We click on create new project, and we're going to choose .NET Maui app project. And the framework version that we need to use is the 7.0. So I just installed this. That's why I can see you have all this new. Okay, so we choose this and we go for the next. And now the name here, let's give it as demo. So I'll choose the location. I'll change the location. So I'll go for projects folder, and the solution name is demo. So click on next. And now the framework version is 7.0. So let's choose that. So click on create, and I will wait for our .NET Maui app to get created. Now, when this project gets created, we are not going to do anything. We are going to just build this application and run it using our simulator. That is an Android emulator. Then when we are done, we have to then build this project and package it as an Android app. You know, before you get it as an Android app, you have to create a key as a signing key as well. So we're going to use that. We're going to do that using the PowerShell. So we have to build this. Right click on the project, and now let's go to build. Okay, so let's accept that, and let's wait for this to build. As you can see from here, restoring NuGet packages. So we wait for this to get done, then we move on. Alright, so as you can see, that you see the build succeeded, and now it is done. So let's go for our emulator, and let's run it. So framework, and I'll choose Android. So in here, let's see, we can go in there for this Android emulators. Let's see if we have any then. Okay, so let's go to tools, then Android and Android device manager. Okay, so we have these emulators downloaded, and we have a 12.0 and 13.0, so we can use any. So default, let's start with this. Let's click on this and let's see which one gets started. So we wait while the running is being done. So let's wait for the output. So it's going to launch this, the emulator. Okay, so the app is now built, and you can see that it is here in our emulator. So that is the default one. As you can see, when you create a new project, that is it. So now let's say this app is ready and we want to publish this to an APK whereby we can install locally on our mobile Android phones. So in such case, what can we do? Now we've learned how to use the user interface, and that one is in the video. So I'll put the link. But this, we are going to talk about using the command line, that's a PowerShell, to build the application or to package it. So let's see how to go about this. Now the first thing to do here is let's stop the debugging mode, and now we have to go for tools, then command line, then go for developer PowerShell. So let's navigate to the projects. So ls to display the list. So cd change directory, then we're going to use the name of the project, that is demo. So ls, we are in here, so we are inside the project. Now instead of typing all this command tools to get the key or the signing key generated, we can go to the documentation, then we can check. So when we go to learn.microsoft.com, and you can see for Android deployment published using the CLI, you can see that here the first thing to do is we have to create a key store file. So you can come here and read a lot about the key store itself, but that is the signing key that we need, and that is what the app needs so that it can be recognized in the app environment for installation. So there is a way to create it. Now run this key tool. We have to provide the following parameters. So we have the key tool and generate a pair. And as you can see from here, we have the key store. We're passing the name.keystore, that's the extension. So alias, and we have key algorithms. We're using the RSA. We have key size, and we have validity of 100,000. Okay, so let's copy this. And let's go to our PowerShell, and now in here we paste this, and we have to make these changes. So let's make these changes. So let's say this is demo. Okay, so we can set this to, this is demo.keystore, then with the alias we can give it as, so demo app key. So that's an alias, demo app key. Then you see we have this key store. So when we are done, you see there's a validity, and these are the two things that we need to make changes to it. So aside from that, let's run this, and now it is requesting to enter password. So I'm going to pass in 1 2 3 4 5 6, then we enter it again, 1 2 3 4 5 6. So it's going to ask you a question, what is the first and the last name? So let's say this is the netcode. So netcode hub. And now what's the name of the organization? So the same netcode. Now the name of the, so here it is asking out the organization you need, and then the same thing. So now city, and that is Accra, and the states, so let's say the same Accra, and what is the two letter country code? So GH, and it is asking us this information that we provided, is it correct? So let's type in yes, and now we wait for this to generate this, the key. So now we have this key over here, as you can see, and that is a demo.keystore. So when we navigate to our project file, we can see, we can find the key store over here. So let's open it. And that is, because we have demo.keystore. So that's the key that we have now. Now, once you have the signing key created, the next thing to do here is to build the project or publish the application. So in this, we're going to specify the key as well. So in order to publish this, let's see, to type all this, let's check the documentation and let's grab it over there. So to publish it, when it comes, you can see we have all the parameters and their values explained. So we see You can use a single key of F, or you can use double dash of what framework. This is a configuration, and here that's the value that we're going to provide. So framework, we're going to choose 7.0 for the Android because that's what we are using. And you can see the configuration too, we're going to use what release mode, not debug. So this is release. And you can see we have application title, we have this application ID, a version, and etc. So Android key store, we have to also provide it as well. So when you come here, that is what we have here. So we can, you can see that we have it .NET publish, and it's 7.0 Android. You see the C here configuration release, and we have the Android key store as true, and that is the Android key store name. So you're going to provide in the demo.keystore. Then here, the alias, we're going to provide the alias name. Then we're going to provide the password that we provided. Aside from that, we're going to also, as you can see, this is a signing key password. And now the same signing key store password. So we're going to confirm the password over there. Then we move on. So that is what you can see from here. We have .NET published. And we have the framework of 7.0. Configuration is released. We have the key easing or key store is true. And you can see from here that we have the key store here, my app.keystore. And the alias is what my app. And as you can see, you know, the password is my password. And the same password has been repeated twice over here. So let's grab this. And let's go to the PowerShell. Now in here, let's paste this. And let's make some changes in it. So we start from the file name. So we see there's a file name has been here. So we see it is starting from .NET publish. We have the framework. We have the release mode. We have using of key store. Then we have to provide the file name here. So let's clear this. And the name that we use here is demo. So we provide demo. Aside from that, the alias that we use here is what demo app key. So let's clear this. And demo app key. Then, you know, we provide a password of 123456. So we pass it over here. 123456. And let's repeat the same password over here too. So 123456. Okay, so now let's run this and let's see what's gonna do. So you can see it has started building this project. So let's wait for this build to be done. Then let's see our signing key. So it is saying that it is not able to load this. We must have internet connection. So let's see. So my network was down, so it is up and running now. Let's do it again. Now let's see. All right, so you see from here, it is done. It took about 5 to 10 minutes to finish all this. And as you can see, it processed about 73 DLS. That's a libraries that it needs to bind them together. As you can see, it is all set and done now. So as you can see, we are done. Now let's go to the projects folder and let's check our bin and a release folder, specifically Android, to see where we can find this package or this application. So we go to the folder and we are in our demo project. So we open it, we go to the bin folder, and here let's go to the release. So let's go to this 7.0 Android and let's see. So you can see we have it over here, and we have the default one that is a demo.ab, and now there is a sign AAB and there's a sign APK. So if you want to install your application locally, then you can use this APK to install it on your phone, Android phone. But if you want to put it to the Play Store, then you're going to use this as a Play Store file. So that is it for this video. We've seen how to create this video, or how to create an application, how to publish an Android app using the PowerShell CLI. And that is it. So if you want to also learn how to use the user interface mode, then check the description. I'll put a link over there. They can also watch that video and have knowledge in the two parts. Okay, so if you like what I'm doing, give me a thumbs up, and also you can subscribe to this channel. Go to the playlist. We have a lot of projects and lessons over there to help you. And that is it. If you have any issue to you, you can put it at the comment section and we'll attend to you shortly. Thank you. Take care of yourself, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.